Well, Kelly, we're here at the Smith and Wesson booth. Are you feeling lucky?
I think I would be holding this 44 Magnum Hunter. This thing is a little bit ridiculous. Performance center, it's got a full CNC machine barrel with the rail, okay? Removable muzzle brake, so it's separate for cleaning. It's got sights, obviously, but you can put a sight on top if you want to go hunting with it. It's got a nice crisp trigger. All in all, this is pretty ridiculous. I like the look. Black on chrome, looks great. But if 44 Magnum isn't good enough for you, we can go bigger. All right? So we got over here.
Is that a handgun?
Yeah, with a bipod. This is the 460. Look at the cylinder. Look how big it is. Look at the barrel. Still one piece with the rail. But, well, if it's too heavy for you, extend out that bipod for that long range shot.
Now that muzzle brake looks like it came off an AK-47.
You know, I couldn't tell you that it didn't. It may have.
So Kelly, do you actually know some guys who do some hunting with big pistols like this?
I don't, but I can see the attraction. I feel a little bit more badass holding this alone. So I can see the niche.
But in reality, what you're giving yourself a firearm that is capable of taking deer, but stowing in a backpack. That's the real advantage. That you have a hard-hitting hunting instrument that is very easy to carry around, much easier than a rifle.
I would agree, yeah. This is very small, very well concealable, not in the way to carry it as a concealed carry, but in the woods. You know, you'd have a lot of room for the rest of your gear you'd need while you're hunting.
We dropped by the Sig Sauer booth and found some interesting new pistols. The first is a 22 caliber version of the classic 1911. We're now in the 100th year history of that pistol. What do you think, Kelly?
You know, I own a 1911 myself, and I think owning a 22 one is a, you know, it's a good thing to do. You'll be able to target practice a lot more inexpensively. Now, some key features of this one retain all the 1911 features you'd be used to. It's even got an ambidextrous safety. Now, key differences would be, obviously, the slide spring is a lot lighter, so I can move it really easily. But the important things, the grip safety, notice there? Still there, and it's functional. I've seen some others that they don't feel the same as a regular centerfire 1911. This one feels pretty good. It feels very similar to the 1911 I have. It's got good sights. It's got a nice trigger. I like the grips. Overall, you know, I'd recommend this as a pistol. It's really pretty nice. I don't know what the price tag is on it, but typically speaking, it's a little cheaper than the centerfire.
What's the advantage to having a 22 caliber version of your defensive pistol?
Well, the advantage is you can practice more often and you don't have to really worry so much about it. You don't have to do any reloading, just go down to Walmart, buy a couple bucks of ammo, and you can go shoot all day long. Now, the other way to do it is to get the 22 conversion, and that's something I have. I have a 22 conversion myself, and then you get to practice with the same trigger. But in a situation like this, this is such a nice pistol all of itself. Man, I kind of want to get this.
One thing I've got to tell our readers, you'll see that Kelly does have a finger in the trigger guard, which is not advisable, but these guns have been completely decommissioned. They have no firing pins, so they're not capable of firing around. We're on our second stop at the Sig Sauer booth, and we found a gun that's really kind of close to my heart, the Sig P210 that has been reintroduced this year as the P210 Legend. Kelly, what do you think of the P210? It's a handsome gun, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, this gun really is a good looker. You look at the grip here, it's wood wraparound, okay? Really looks pretty nice. It feels great to hold. Something really notable is the trigger. It feels like this trigger has been worked over by a skilled gunsmith, and it looks like it's gonna come from the factory like this. Now, the trigger on here is such that, not being a pistol shooter, I'm pretty convinced I can shoot this accurately. It just looks like this is a pistol that's gonna lend itself for accuracy.
How does the gun point?
Well, looking down, it really grips in your hand. It just sits pretty well, and it points very naturally, same way a 1911 would.
Now, this is a single action, isn't it?
It is.
So that would make it sort of a complement to a 1911 if you had a 45 ACP.
Correct, yeah. This would simulate some of the same things as a 1911. Some key differences, though, do make it a little more towards a Beretta. The shape of the barrel, for example, you look at that, even just along here on the top, looks a little kind of like a Beretta. But the trigger, much like a 1911, you'll have to pull it straight back.
One nice feature we found, there's an optional rear sight. It's not on this gun, but they make a rear sight that actually has three positions, so you can change your zero to adjust to different yardages. $2,000, what do you think?
$2,000? Sure, it's a great deal for someone.